Things about waves like that hitting our coast are raising questions. Were emergency alerts sent to affected areas fast enough? Some who evacuated early this morning say they received an alert hours after the initial jolt. Sam Kelway explains.
An unmissable alert.
This warning is for the west coast of Auckland.
Heard by hundreds of thousands of people.
The alerts have been going off on the phone, and we're just sitting here waiting to see what's going on.
In some areas, tensions were at boiling point as parents rushed to pick up children. However, officials insisting the communication execution was a success.
Are we satisfied that people knew what to do at the critical times and that ultimately they could stay safe? I think in the round, the answer is yes.
Others arguing it was far from it.
I'm not making too clear of what you're supposed to be doing. So I went down the beach this morning and it was low tide and I grabbed me a few crayfish.
I think it needs to be a whole lot better. There's a whole lot of people that lived out further out the coast, especially Wainui, who didn't know if they should be evacuating or not. Some people didn't even wake up to the earthquake and may not have even known about the warnings.
Those who were woken by the jolt in the middle of the night wondering why the alert wasn't sent earlier.
There's a lot of confusion, yeah. Civil Defence has sort of changed their policy and what they do over the last few years, and there's a lot of unknowns.
The Emergency Management Minister backing the system, saying there's room for improvement and praising those residents who wasted no time in evacuating. The tsunami warning's since been cancelled, but the Minister's still asking people to be alert.
Whilst there is no longer the restrictions on being able to go down into the beach, please do exercise prudent judgment.
Judgment accepted by most, many in Whakatane who endured the scorching temperatures up high.
Are you happy to go, Eddie? So
yeah, I'm going home, yay!
Relieved to be making their way down when the alerts were lifted.
And Sam is with us now live from Whakatane. A long, hot wait for those wanting to return home, Sam.
A very long, hot day indeed. Many people seeking shelter at Hillcrest Lookout, where thousands of people were evacuated too. And while there was some criticism around the evacuation alerts, many people here in Whakatane remained mostly calm. Police set up cordons right around the region and encouraged people to get to higher ground. Fire and Emergency New Zealand handed out bottles of water and at one stage even opened up a fire hydrant to let adults and kids and pets have some water. Today, this afternoon in Whakatane, it's been reasonably quiet. I think many people have gone home after a very early start.
Tēnā koe, Sam, in Whakatane. Sam Kelway.